Do you like pickles? I like pickles. Ida, you like pickles, don't you?
I adore pickles. I went to New York on Pickle Day once with my dad.
Pickle Day?
And we went to a pickle restaurant.
Oh.
Yeah.
I love pickles. I love chutney. Do you make chutney?
I do. I make a lot of chutney.
Good.
Well, in fact, we have what food writers call the godmother of pickling with us this morning. She's going to show us some of her secrets. Alex Elliott, welcome to Studio 2.
Thank you. Thank you.
Now, what are we making to begin with?
So today we're going to make fennel pickle, which is one of our biggest sellers and an excellent pickle to make in winter. Mm-hmm. So obviously traditionally pickles are cucumbers and zucchinis, but they're not around at the moment.
Okay.
So we're always looking for things in winter to pickle as well.
All right, what can we do?
All right, so I've already sliced up some fennel here. Mm-hmm. I like to use everything, so I use the stalks and the fronds as well because I don't like to throw anything away. Oh. So I've sliced that up very finely with some onions in there as well. Mm-hmm. And then we're going to spice it. So today I thought we'd add a few fennel seeds. Maybe you can put those in. Just get them with your fingers. Yeah.
So spice is more than salt and pepper, right?
Well, there's salt in our vinegar brine, so more for flavouring. Little bit more. I like a bit of chili in my fennel pickle. Chuck a bit of that in.
Oh,
it depends how hot you like it.
How does one become the godmother of pickling?
It's very hard to know. It was not in my game plan, I can tell you. I started pickling at home when I was a stay-home mum with my babies, and really decided that I wanted to change the way that we ate. So really fell in love with seasonal eating. Reducing waste, knowing what goes into food, and preserving symbolises all that stuff
and
for
you
me.
Teach
and I fell
it
in
too,
love.
Don't
yes,
you?
I teach pickling workshops at the Picklery. I own a Picklery of all things.
Picklery.
Yes.
And is that at your restaurant, your cafe?
No, well, we've got the cafe in Marrickville and the Picklery just up the road.
That's a great cafe.
Thank you.
There's
very
always
much.
A line.
There is, and we're in the midst of opening another one in Annandale.
Oh.
Yes, I know. It's very exciting.
Do you
exciting.
Want to say where?
All in Sydney. Street, Annandale.
All right,
and you
then.
Want to put this in
yes,
there?
Yes, no. So what we're going to do is pack jars. So
yes,
maybe you
okay.
can start packing the fennel in there.
Okay, just now pans in.
Pans in.
What, as simple as that?
Up. It's so easy. Pickling is the easiest preserving you can do. Ita, do you want to pack a
Pete,
jar
how
as well?
How are you with pickle tongue twisters, Pete?
Which was what?
Peter Piper picked the peppers.
All right.
Gosh, is she not good at everything, this woman? What is it?
My mother taught me.
You are.
My mother taught me it.
Now hold your tongue and say it 10 times.
All right, we're going to keep packing that in.
Yeah, so we really pack it in, do you?
Yeah, as tight as you can.
You don't cook that at all. You
no,
just put it straight
in.
Do we sterilise the bottles?
Yes, so the jars are sterilised.
Right.
Hot soapy wash.
You can look that online how to do it.
Hot soapy wash and a rinse and into the oven. You don't need to boil them.
Oh, you don't? That's
no,
what I
it's old-fashioned.
Oh, really?
Yeah. Just dry them in the oven.
Okay.
So then what we need to do is get some of that boiling brine. Would you
like which
to do
is
that
boiling.
Piece?
Boiling, all right.
No, it's really boiling.
It'll take your breath away, Ida.
No,
watch. Well, you take your hand away. I'm nervous.
Okay, all right.
So what's in the brine
again?
So
the brine is vinegar, water, sugar and salt. So 4 parts vinegar, 2 parts water, 1 part sugar and salt to
there
taste.
You are. There you go.
And then I might pour that on top.
Yeah.
And what you've got to do is pour slowly to completely cover all the vegetables.
And
so that's what's preserving
that.
It. So it's just blanching it because you want a crunchy pickle, not a soggy pickle.
This is actually very good for the stomach too, isn't
very
it?
Very good for the stomach. I mean, it's not fermenting, but it is pickling. We do need to introduce more vinegars into our diet.
Yeah.
And you've got to make sure that all your vegetables are completely submerged because that's going to stop the bacteria from growing. We're going to give it a tap. All right, so you can just go in there with a knife and get rid of air bubbles.
And how do you know that, you know, you're not eating, you're actually eating proper pickle and not bacteria? Does it actually grow? If you do it the wrong way.
Look, if there's black mould on top, don't eat
it. Okay, all right.
Yeah. Otherwise,
I was
it should
going
be
to
fine.
Ask you that because sometimes with the chutneys I buy at the church fates, which I love as a chutney and pickles, there could be a little bit of mould forming.
Yes, look, just.
Can I scoop that off?
If it's white mould, scoop it off.
Oh.
If it's black mould, don't eat it.
And do you refrigerate this? Do you put a.
No, so we're just going to pop the lid on top. And you can feel how hot that is.
Mm-hmm.
Lid on top, nice and hot. And then what will happen is the lid starts to puff up with the heat.
Right.
And then as it cools down, a vacuum forms inside and sucks that lid down so it seals it.
Oh, that's why it pops when we take it off.
And how long does it take to pickle a peck of pickles?
Ideally, you'd try and let it sit for a month before you ate
it.
But look, a lot of people get excited and just want to eat it the next day.
What would you what would you have these pickles with?
So we serve them at the cafe on our ploughman's plates.
Mm.
Really nice on a toasted sandwich.
Ooh.
They're great with fish. Really nice to a salad. So if you're making a fennel salad, you could add a bit of extra pickles through there as well.
And corned beef, things
corned
like that,
beef,
the American
absolutely.
Thing you were talking
delicious.
About.
Delicious. Mm. Do you want to try some? I bought some that I already picked.
Oh, yes, please.
All right.
It smells like my grandmother's house. She does sauerkraut and stuff like this.
Yeah, absolutely. It's a beautiful smell. And I've got some
And you've had famous people come to your restaurant. Jamie Oliver or something?
Oh, yes, Jamie Oliver was very kind to us and loves our pickles and loves what we do because we're really about supporting good food.
That's fantastic.
Sources. That's gorgeous.
That's a pickle zucchini.
See, I love, I buy these and you can make them yourself.
Oh, so easy. The easiest thing you can do.
So there's sugar in that, right?
Yeah, not too much, though.
That is so delicious.
Now, we will put this recipe on our Facebook page and you can find more great recipes in the book Corner Smith by Alex and her hubby James. Thank you so much for coming in and showing us how to cook these.
Thank you.